What's up everybody, welcome back to another video from Exotic Astrology. And today, what should we discuss? Today's topic is very it's very delighting. At the same time, it's going to clear many misconceptions which people have about spirituality, okay? Because sometimes people have utopian concepts of what spirituality is, what spirituality is not, okay? And then when they have these expectations and when they start off with something and they do not end up there, then they are like, oh, it doesn't work. If you have yet not subscribed to my channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you have any questions, queries or comments for this video, then please let me know, okay? I have named this video as Smashing Misconceptions About Spirituality. Because many times we have conceptions or other misconceptions which actually hinder us from going close to God. Let me give you an example. It's always good to start with examples, right? No? Well, that's my style. Instead of going to the theory, why not go to something practical? There was once a villager, okay? And this villager got the news that there's going to be rain everywhere. And so you have to evacuate the place, okay? But he didn't pay much heed to it. And then what happened? There was severe rain, okay? And this person used to claim that he's a great follower of God. He has tremendous faith in God, which is great. There's nothing wrong in that. It's beautiful, it's great, it's very rare. But this person, when there were severe rains, then what happened? He told all his family members that I will not evacuate this place. I will wait till God protects me. He said, unless God comes and protects me, I will not leave this place. I have full faith in God that he will come and protect me. I have full, absolute, unflinching faith that he will do it. And then the rain was increasing. And the flood started getting high. And then finally, the time came when everybody in the village evacuated with the helicopters. But this person was sitting in the roof of his house. His house was also drowned almost. And then this fellow sitting with his hands like this, he went and told that the authorities asked him from the sky, who were in the helicopter. They said, we have come to rescue you. Come, please come. Please come with us. He said, no, unless God protects me, I will not come. And then the flood was increasing. It started touching his body. And then the authorities again said, my dear sir, please come. Otherwise, you will die. He said, no, I don't need your help. God will protect me. And then the water reached to his neck. Yes. And again the authority shouted, my dear sir, please. Do not do this to yourself. Please come. And what he said? Unless God protects me, I will not come, even if I die. I know he will protect me. And then finally the water caught him till the head and he died. So now what will skeptics say? Hey, look, God didn't protect. Yes, that's what they will say, right? Skeptics, atheists, agnostics, the big group. But the problem is not in The question, did God protect him or not? The problem is in his approach to the idea of God's protection. That has to be re-examined. Generally, people, whenever they think that God will help, they expect that it will happen in some supernatural way. Suddenly, out of nowhere, one day I will get up and it will disappear. We expect like that, right? It doesn't happen like that. And it doesn't need to happen like that. Because if God is all powerful, he can do it in a natural way also. Why does he need a supernatural way to do it? That means God was actually protecting him when he had sent that, when he sent those helicopters to protect him. But this foolish fellow had some utopian conception about God's protection. And then later, when that didn't work out as what he thought, he died. Yes. So it simply means that whenever we pray to God, the help can come from any means. Okay. It does not have to be some supernatural means. That can also happen at times. There are examples in cases. But that's not the norm of the society all the time. That's not the way it happens most of the times. So if we think that whenever we are praying to God, the things have to happen suddenly out of nowhere, that is an unrealistic expectation which we are having from God. And when that is not fulfilled, we become like conditional followers. Yes. What do I mean by the word conditional follower? Conditional follower simply means they will only go to God till the time their needs are met, till the time God is very faithfully, loyally, like an obedient servant. God is clicking yes, yes, yes to all his demands. The moment God says question mark, maybe or no, he's like, oh God, you don't exist for me. That is why people say sometimes, oh, I did so much this, that, religion, spirituality, I did so much. What did I get at the end, right? There you go. What if the mother also starts saying, I have done so much for the child, now what has the child given me? She can say, right? When, suppose you are married or you are in a relationship, when the partner is angry, that time if you say, just get lost, I have nothing to do with you, I will only stay with you if you are good with me. Well, can any relationship work out like that? No, right? So perseverance, tolerance is required in every area of life, and spirituality is not an exception. We cannot have utopian, imaginary, self-constructed definitions and think that it has to happen this way only. Otherwise, it's not God's way. Maybe it's something else, but maybe God is not helping me. Somebody else is helping. No, nobody is helping you. It is God only who is helping you through the person. So if that fellow would have taken the help of the helicopter, he would have been saved. Because ultimately, the scriptures tell us that God is the doer. Well, then what we are doing? We are all instruments. And then we understand that actually God is the one who is doing everything. Then we will understand, okay, this helicopter has come to help me, that means God has sent help. Otherwise, maybe this helicopter would not be here. Yes, without his desire, how can the helicopter be here? That's not possible. Am I clear? So tolerance, perseverance and faith, like it is required in every area of life, in terms of our career, in our workplace, that is also required in relationships. Tremendous tolerance. You have to be able to handle your partner at his or her worst. Then only you deserve to handle him or her at his best, right? If you cannot handle your partner at his or her worst, who gave you the right that you will be there with them during their best times? No, you don't deserve to be. So similarly, in good and bad, both the times when we remain faithful to our spiritual practices, we do not leave them just because things are not going the way we want it to go, okay? Not that things are not going right. Things are not going right the way we want them to go as right, okay? When it's not going right that way, we do not give up our practices, whatever we are doing, provided we are doing something. If you are not doing anything at all, then this video doesn't make any sense, right? That is it from my side. If you have any questions, queries and comments, then please let me know. And if you have not subscribed to my channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you like this video, then share it with your family, friends and members. Or if you know somebody who feels that it has to be this way or it is not God's way. Okay. That is it from my side. I wish you all the best. Until next time. Bye-bye. See you.